This is a truth soldier message. Jesus was an atheist. So for all of you people out there who don't really like religions and get all screwed up in the head when you think about religions, well, hey, I don't think you ever realized that Jesus was not religious. He was a homeless activist. He fought against organized religion. He fought against the moneylenders. And I've asked lots of people in my life, why do people even know his name? Because everything that's ever been written about Jesus in the Bible, saying, claiming that there were Jesus' words, well, the first Bible wasn't written for at least 500 years after Jesus existed. And Jesus never wrote anything. So why do we remember his name? What was it about him that we remember? It has to be his actions. It has to be what he was doing, as well as what he might have been saying, but what he was doing. So think about it. What was Jesus doing? He was setting the example for all of us to know God. And Jesus said he had God in him, and he knew God, and he wanted us to know God. And he just lived his life by loving God and doing God's work. And that's not religion. He was going around doing two things. He was going around spreading love and spreading truth. And the thing to realize is love and truth are one and the same, and one cannot exist without the other. So the secret to life is to love truth. But then people will say, well, that person's truth is different than that person's truth. That's not what I'm talking about. Truth is an action. It only exists when you seek it and speak it. That's not to say that if a person tells you something one day, that it may not change, what they think may not change a few days later. It's not that they're trying to lie to you or deceive you. Is there's truth changes. Truth has to constantly be sought, because you have to be flexible. And I know you quite can't, you know, you probably cannot quite understand what I'm saying. It's quite difficult to try to explain the spirit of being a human being, because people always have a problem. They always use words. When I wrote an article years ago, How to Think Without Words, you should have a look at it. And then you might understand that God is a word that human beings use, because human beings use words. And God is not a person, it's not a being. God is the universe. It's the energy of the universe. It's the spirit of the universe. And we are made from God and of God. That's why we're all God's sons and daughters. And Jesus was God's son, and he was sent down by God, and so were we. I've had conversations with lots of people, and I've explained to them about their spirituality. When you're born perfect. And so the goal in your life is to you to realize you're on a journey. And you have to realize that you're on a spiritual journey. And in nature, there's only one rule. Only perfection continues. So for your spirit to continue, like Jesus was trying to tell us, after death, what is it you have to achieve? You have to achieve perfection. So you have to perfect your spirit. And a person who speaks truth and seeks truth always ends up having a perfect spirit. Because the truth is absolute. And the further you go from truth, you arrive at the opposite absolute. So if you avoid truth, you don't seek truth, you end up at the opposite absolute, which is insanity, which is where the devil dwells, and Satanists are, and child molesters, and the pedophiles, and all the sickest people in the world are at the bottom. And I always tell people that you have to seek God, because God is a word we use, but you have to seek the Spirit of God and make that part of your spirit. And realize that's what you have to do. When you're born, you're on a journey of maturity. And what has to mature is your spirit. You have to empower your spirit. And the only thing that empowers you, the individual, is what we call truth. So, in this day and age, I'm watching the whole planet dying. I'm watching all the trees dying all over the planet. All the wildlife is dying. human beings are becoming, literally becoming really screwed up in the head. They're all lost. They're all sitting, walking around with a little digital screen in front of them, pushing buttons all day long. They don't know how to communicate one-on-one with other people. Because everybody around them is becoming stranger and stranger. Everyone's becoming a stranger. And you know that, how that happened? Because the only thing you could ever have in common with another person so that they're not a stranger is truth. And a long time ago, Canada was built, is a Commonwealth country that was built on truth. And for the love of God. So what would happen is that people would share truth with each other. They'd be kind, they'd be loving by being truthful. They weren't trying to be better than someone else. They were just trying to help people like Jesus was doing. So now what do we have today? We have a whole bunch of, a whole generation of people, at least from 40 years and younger, that are all grown up with a screen in front of their face. And I've warned people long ago about, I said, beware of the one-dimensional mind. Because the one-dimensional mind is created by someone that who stares at a screen, watching an artificial life in front of them. And so these young people, they grow up with this screen in front of their face, and then they go out to live their life, they act and react to everything. So their whole life is an act, and they think everything around them is an act. And what's lacking in these individuals' makeup, mental makeup, is intellect. And intellect is achieved by going out and seeking truth. And the trick to life is that you can't know what truth is. You can't possibly know what it is. You're literally blinded by it when you go to seek it. And so what you have to do is you have to slowly learn how to be truthful. You have to know the meaning of the word truth. You have to know how to seek truth. And as you learn to seek truth and you learn to understand what truth is, you realize that truth is the path to your spirit and the path to what we call God and the spirit of the universe. Now, this idea that we, all human beings, die and our souls die and we die forever, well, I have a problem with that because there's so many falsehoods or errors in religion. And I wrote an article years ago called Infinity. And I explained to people that the Big Bang Theory, the idea that God created the whole universe all at once and before that there was nothing, is an impossibility. Because if there was nothing before God created the universe, then there wouldn't have been a God either, would there? So what you have to realize about infinity is this. Time has always existed. You can use a telescope to look into the universe and get a bigger telescope and a bigger one. And every time you do, you just see more and more and more and more. You can get a microscope and look and you see more and more and more life. And then you get a bigger, a more powerful microscope and you see more and more and more life. What you have to realize is that everything around you is infinite. So if that scares you and makes you wonder, how am I supposed to relate to anything? Well, you have to realize that you exist. So what you have to learn to understand is what is reality. And the only thing that is reality is anything that is truth. Anything that is truth is pure. Because truth can only be pure. So now you're realizing that, okay, so infinity goes on in every direction forever and ever, and that means so does time. So in life, when you're going out to seek truth, you have to realize that's the action, seeking truth. So the action is your direction. It's your journey. And you are empowering your spirit to become part of the universe. The more you learn to mature your spirit, and the more you learn how to seek truth and understand how truth works. And be careful not to let words get in the way when you're trying to understand your spirituality, because human beings are the only creatures that use words. If you were to actually watch cats and dogs and wildlife and birds or anything else, and if you're in tune with nature, you would realize that all living things have emotions, have a family bond, they have relationships, they have different personalities. So what happened on our planet? I told people long ago, I said, you know, native people never lie. Could you see a native person lie to the birds and the bees and the rocks and the trees? Lying is not natural. And remember that anyone who seeks truth is a person who goes out and understands the smell of fresh air, the sun that comes up in the day, the clouds. People that are native are people that are natural, and they relate to the natural world. And what has happened in our society in the last 100 years? Society no longer relates to anything that's natural. And this is why you've got these people with one-dimensional minds that are stuck with screens in front of their faces. And then you got other idiots out there now that are working in the labs and are creating vaccines that are poisoning people. And they're creating artificial foods, GMOs, they're cloning life, and they're doing, people today have gone so insane. They are altering everything that's natural. So I'm looking at the insanity all around me. And I'm realizing, what is missing? What is going on? What's the single thing that can save this world from all this insanity? The love of God is the only thing that can save you. Have a look at my poem that's on my Folk Photographer YouTube channel that comes on when you first arrive there. It's called I'm in Love and I'm So Happy. That should help you a little bit on your path. But you have to realize you are a spiritual being. there's a lot of wise old sayings, and one of them is about God. We keep using the word God, but God's not a man or a woman. God is a word we use. But God is the spirit of the universe. It's what makes the universe work. And I always tell people, remember that there's only positive energy. There's no such thing as negative energy. And if you're living a positive energy and you live by truth and you live by the power of God in you, I tell people all the time, if you've got God in you, you cannot and you should never live in any fear of anything, because your spirit will not die if you're pure. The old days, they called people that became really pure Christians, the new God and Jesus and all that. That they say when you die, you come back as an angel. Well, that's your journey you're on. If you perfect your spirit continues. And believe me, there's plenty of room in this universe for spiritual beings to fly around on the angel wings to go out and do miracles and other wonderful things at other planets in the world or in the universe where there's life beginning and things. So, you can never possibly have all the answers to the whole universe. But in your life, if you don't want to be lost, okay, when you're seeking truth, there's one thing you've got to avoid. Never, ever try to understand why there's a rock on the ground, why there was water, why. Because if you keep trying to understand why, you're going to be lost. All you have to understand is what is. Yes, there is a rock. Yes, there is water. Yes, that plant is healthy. Yes, that one's dying. You have to know truth. And when you know truth, then you know the work of God. And if you go out and seek and speak truth, then you're doing the work of God. And if you're always seeking truth, you're developing your intellect. Because the only thing that empowers the individual is not a gun, is not trickery with words, it's not anything but truth. And that's what I'm telling you right now. I'm telling you truth. We are in trouble in this world because this planet is about to die. And the reason why it's dying is because everyone has become ill. The mental psyche of humanity today is so ill. It is scary for me to understand what I see. I did another article a while back. It's called Top Secret Extraterrestrial Message. Go listen to it. And when you hear alien, I'm just telling you now, I didn't write this in the article, but for people that have read it, they never got the message. They didn't realize that alien means God. Go read it and you'll understand what my message is. Now, I have done everything I can. I have spent my life showing you miracles, like the Son of God photo that I have. I've written extraordinary enlightenment things, but I understand that YouTube and the internet is being censored. It's being controlled. They control your view counts. They control who you can communicate with. They control because they have no self-control. And I always warn people about the insane in this world. The insane are those who seek and speak no truth. And the insane have no self-control, because the only way you can seek and speak truth is to have self-control. So the insane are fucking up this planet. And they seek to control us. But now what's happening is there's less and less and less sane people on this planet. So what are the insane going to control? If they're trying to control the people that are sane, and there's not too many sane people left, what are the insane going to control? Nothing. The insane are going to die along with this planet. There's an illness happening here. It's a mental illness. It's an illness of avoiding truth. And when you're avoiding truth, you're avoiding a word that we call God. You know, I'm almost 60 years old. I've been inquisitive all my life. I've talked to old people when I was very young, and I asked them about their past and how life is and different things. And, you know, I got involved with the creation of the World Wide Web, and I don't care what anybody says. The World Wide Web was created in Toronto in 1971. It was a hippie idea to create a network for humanity to communicate truth with each other, because way back then even they knew there was something wrong in this world. The people that took control of the creation of money have corrupted the whole planet. They've corrupted people's minds. They've corrupted everything. So the World Wide Web right now is really, really becoming empowered to the point where all the insane and the criminals can no longer influence us. They're losing their power permanently because people are waking up to truth. But remember what Donald Trump said in his inauguration speech. He told you the truth. He told you about God and he told you about Jesus. So next time you hear talk about Jesus, you better stop thinking that's religion. For all of you people who don't like religions, which I don't necessarily blame you, you realize Jesus was not talking to you about religion. That's why the religions were created, because Jesus was an individual with a message from the universe, from his spirit, from God, that would empower you, the individual. And all you had to do was do what he showed you. Go out and spread love and go out and spread truth. So now I think you understand what's been going on. Now I've put some pleas on the internet for help because I've been under attack in this country of Canada, which is now becoming an Islamic state. They have destroyed my life. They're destroying people all over the world. But they've really come after me because Islam is terrified of who I am. And the purity of my love for God, for my godly love that I give to people, that I've done my whole life. If you see a plea because I'm out of gas or out of food or I'm in trouble, and I'm not begging you, but I'm saying to you, if you care about somebody or you care about me, what I've been doing all my life, which is quite evident by looking on the internet and putting my name in a search engine or looking around. Everything I've done in my life was for the same reason Jesus did it. I gave of myself. I shared my love with other people. I shared my kindness. I showed my beauty to people that have never seen a beautiful soul. I've done exactly what Jesus did my whole life because I understood his message. Now, that's the answer to saving our planet. Because God told us long ago, help comes to those who help themselves. It's time for us to help this planet. God gave us perfection. God gave us heaven, and we're living in it. It's not floating out in outer space. This planet was perfect. It was in balance until that illness took over our planet that we call money. Money is not the illness, though, because money was just a bartering system for people to trade work. So that in itself is not evil or bad. It's actually necessary. It's just that unfortunately criminals have done so much harm on this planet. So now you have no excuses anymore for not trying to do your best to make this world a better place. And I'm sitting out here right now in a weird place. And it's kind of cold outside, but that's okay. I'm resting underneath a highway overpass. I'm quite homeless. I'm quite like Jesus was. I still go out and spread my inner beauty. I still make people happy when they meet me. I'm still very kind. In spite of what people have said, I'm never ever going to stop being of God. And I'm God's son. But you see, you have to realize that Jesus was God's son. And we're all God's children. And if we don't accept God's love that a good parent gives to its children, its offspring, then you are not going to survive. Because you don't have the perfection of God and the perfection of love in your soul and in your spirit. And without letting another human being share some love with you of kindness and inner beauty and showing their beauty, you can't exist. Because you know what makes us human? What's really amazing and makes us human? Human beings have to acknowledge each other. Just like a bee pollinates a flower. Every living thing in our universe, on our planet, depends on another living thing for it to continue living. It's called the balance of nature. And what has happened now is human nature has become corrupted by criminals, by the insane. And remember what I told you, I'm native. And you need to be native. Anyone can be native if they're one with God and one with the natural world. And when you become one with the natural world, you'll realize all those videos and photos and things that I've been doing from across Canada showing you all the trees dying. This planet is dying. It's waiting for you to share your love and start caring. Because the collective energy of humanity will save this planet. But human beings have to overcome this insanity and this evil. And the only way you're going to stop the insane from putting GMOs creating genetic modified organisms or giving you poison vaccines and all the other insanities that are going on, you have to realize what good people are telling you when they tell you these things are evil, these things are bad, these things are poison. Donald Trump is doing it. And Donald Trump came into existence thanks to the World Wide Web that was created as an idea way back in 1971 in Toronto with me and my friends. And I don't care if you don't believe me, I was there. Donald Trump got elected through social media. He got elected because there's an awakening happening. And that awakening is spreading worldwide in any language. Remember, not all people are evil. Not all people that work for corporations or governments are evil. But there's a sickness. A bunch of sick, evil pedophiles, mentally deranged human beings that are, you know, drinking the blood of children, eating their bodies, doing satanic, crazy stuff. You know, there's a lot of horrible evil in the world. But remember, when you go seeking truth, you have to see the evil and you have to see the beauty. You have to look for all truth. And then you'll be able to go on your journey and you pick your path. That's a choice that God gave you. So if you see what's wrong and you see what's right and you do right, then you're on your way and your spirit is maturing. If you don't do what's naturally perfect to do, your spirit will not continue. You will not survive. The planet will not survive. You know, take this video, the recording that I'm doing here. Download it, re-upload it. And keep telling everyone else to download it and re-upload it. Because you know something? If you took this video and you sent it out on your emails, a link to this video, or you downloaded it, and if everybody did the same thing you told them to do, that you're doing, within 24 hours, this video would be all over the planet. And there wouldn't be any more young people going to war to kill innocent people somewhere else. There wouldn't be anybody following crazy, insane, violent religions, which are just cults, some of them. You know, the people out there are lost. People are lost. They need to know what I'm telling you now. You need to spread this message. Now. Don't wait. Don't be selfish. Don't be evil. Don't let your spirit die. Because you don't want to love. Don't let the light of truth go out, because it'll be eternal darkness, and this planet will die very soon. The insane want to have nuclear wars. The insane are unleashing all kinds of insanity. But you know what? All of that can be overcome. It's not hard for you and for humanity to stop all this. You know why? Because the most powerful weapon, most powerful thing in the universe is truth. And remember, as long as everything you do is because of the love of God you have, and the love of God that you accept from God, and don't listen to people that tell you can only communicate to God through Jesus. That's not true either. That's why they keep telling you God was Jesus. I mean, Jesus was God. No, Jesus was one with God. And anyone who has got their spirit attuned to reality, to truth, to love, is one with God. It's the religions that kept messing everybody up. So every time you couldn't find your spiritual path, it's because words were getting in the way. I'm not trying to share words with you here. I'm trying to get you to be a loving human being. When I walk around and I'm not competing with anyone and I meet strangers, I usually, most of the time, I leave people very happy that they've ever met me. And I don't do it for myself. They usually turn around and all of a sudden they're beaming with beauty, and their whole complexion is coming bright, and they're all happy, and they're sharing their beauty with me. And all I did was just show them, this is what you need to do. This is what I need to do. This is what we all need to do. Stop caring about material possessions and money. Start caring about you, about others, about this planet, about the birds and the bees. Start telling and speaking truth. Because the tree of life is dying. The tree of life has to grow from the seeds of truth. And every time you discover a pure truth in your life about reality, about life, about everything that is natural and beautiful, and you share a little bit of that truth with anyone, you're spreading seeds of truth. And that's how humans are supposed to work. That's what the truth you're sharing, believe it or not, is affection. You're sharing love. And it doesn't require any words to share truth. It requires you having, you know, an action, because truth is an action. So when you give of yourself to help someone else, or to help a wildlife creature, or to help this planet, or do you help just by spreading this video, or the parts of the messages in this video, then you're part of the solution to this illness that's happening on our planet. So I pray to God that the people of this world wake up to God's love, because if you don't, you're going to be in eternal darkness. Don't live in any fear, because the way to get rid of the darkness of evil, you can be in a gigantic room and it's full of dark energy all around you, and you're in the dark, and you're so weak. But one little spark of truth can, you know, make all the evil and all the darkness disappear instantly. You light up one little spark of truth in a big dark room. You've got light, and all what happens to the darkness, it scatters away and disappears because the light fills it. Light is the light of God. Light is energy. We are human beings that are born from energy. So the wonderful thing about life is we can never possibly know everything. We don't need to. We need to use our emotions, our senses, our feelings to understand that we are part of a journey. And if you learn to give of yourself and show your inner beauty, and even when you're looking at a horribly, you know, ugly, dirty person that never smiles, you know why a lot of people are evil and they're really, really nasty people? It's because they've never seen unconditional love. Ever. They've never heard a kind word. It is so, so easy to fix this planet. Start spreading the light of God. Start spreading the love. If you accept God's love, you'll have plenty of love to give to others. And then they'll do it. Now you're beginning to understand that all the words that I'm using is only, you know, eventually the words are not necessary once you learn to sense and feel the Spirit of God in you. The Spirit of God cannot be in you unless you make that decision to do that. Because everything you do in your journey, which is your maturity, is a decision you make. You have to choose whether or not you are going to empower your spirit. Remember, anytime you can't find your path in your life, you're letting words get in the way. When you don't know how to deal with something, you can't understand something, or there's something that's affecting your health, just go and go into your soul and go to, you know, reach a spot in your soul where you're at peace with yourself. Trust in the universe. Trust in the energy that I'm describing. Please. The world needs your love. This planet is going to die without it. This planet is dying of loneliness. All the trees are dying. The butterflies are disappearing. The bees are dying. Oh my goodness, everything's dying because there's the love of God is not in your heart. And remember, Jesus was not religious. He was an atheist. So you can proudly call yourself an atheist and tell people you love Jesus and you know what God means and show them what it means. And don't ever live in any fear. And my name is Daniel J. Towsey. Please share this message from God.